Let's take a look at the conservation of charge, very similar to the conservation of energy. Conservation of charge means that the total charge in the universe never changes. Now, this doesn't mean it's impossible to, let's say, create a positive charge. It just means that when we do create a positive charge, we'd better create a negative charge to go along with it. In fact, we can refine this definition. Let's make it a little more specific. Let's say that the total charge in a closed system never changes. Well, what does this mean? What's a closed system? Well, for the purpose of conservation of charge, a closed system means that there's no charge being added to or removed from the system. For example, let's imagine a metallic sphere. This would be, in this case, a closed system. Nothing is touching it, it's just hanging out somehow, and there's no charge being introduced to it, and no charge being removed from it. Now, in reality, this sphere would have to be held by something. So let's say it's held by some stand. And the only important thing is that this stand be what's called an insulator. An insulator is something which doesn't allow charges to move around inside of it. But we'll get to that in a bit. Now, this metallic sphere, just like the human body, is made of atoms. And those atoms contain positive protons and negative electrons. Now let me get rid of some of this stuff so we can focus on the problem at hand. So we mentioned before that our stand has to be an insulator, something in which charges are stuck and can't move. The other end of the spectrum is a conductor, in which electrons are free to move. Now in the case of our conducting sphere, of course the sphere is a conductor, and the positive and negative charges in this neutral conductor are perfectly balanced. I've drawn 7, in reality there'd be trillions and trillions. But what I want to know is, let's say we were somehow able to find a positively charged object. This has a net positive charge, and we could bring it close to this conducting sphere. Can you think about this problem? And tell me, what will the charge distribution in this sphere look like when we bring this charge close? So which of these pictures best indicates what the charge distribution in this sphere will look like once we've brought a positive charge close to the right-hand side? Now, you have to think about this for a minute. Think of what it means to be a conductor. Think of what sorts of charges are attracted and repelled, and I think you can probably get this one right. Good luck.